intent and purpose, turned the 1910 dictaphone into a cylinder phonograph. So I can make good, loud, bright recordings, and I can play it back through a standard, which is that horn. So this opens a lot of doors, a lot of possibilities. It makes for a very inexpensive cylinder phonograph. And, you know, if you can't afford an Edison cylinder phonograph, this would be a real great stop measure, a stopgap, because you can learn how to record on a cylinder phonograph for probably a third of what it would cost you to buy a Edison cylinder phonograph. So recording on the 1910 dictaphone, recording on it as a phonograph, not a dictation machine. We're running at 160 RPM. I'm recording with a speaking tube, and I'm going to play this